Hello everyone, I'm Photo2s and today I'm revisiting an idea that I had a couple months ago of making a chocolate Yutus figure. Now, as you might know, it didn't work out that well back then, so I'm doing it again today and hope that it's gonna be better. Now, this is also a great idea to do now because we are getting close to Christmas and we can maybe make some Yutus sweets or something as a Christmas special, so we have to prepare. Now let's get started. When I first attempted this, I had no knowledge about chocolate, and I had no idea how to make chocolate stay together and harden into a shape. So I did my research this time, and it turns out that chocolate is really difficult. And to make it stay together in a shape and harden, you have to temper it. If you don't know what tempering is, it's pretty much making the chocolate very small. As you can see that I'm doing right now, I'm chopping it very, very thinly. And then you melt it and you make sure that it stays within a certain range of degrees. Otherwise, it's gonna get out of the tempering range and you have to cool it down or start over again. It depends on your case, but it's really difficult. And I had nothing to measure the temperature with, at least not for chocolate. So I just used my own technique, which was pretty much putting my finger in the chocolate and seeing if it's too hot. And if it's not hot to the touch, then that means that it's about in the tempering range. Now, the way that you melt the chocolate is also important because you don't have to get direct heat. That's why I used a bowl which I put on top of a pot with a bit of water on the bottom. Now, very important thing is that the water doesn't have to touch the bowl. And once everything was melted, I poured it into the mold. Now, this was also quite difficult because I put them all together and the only way of me putting the chocolate in was through the holes of the feet, which were very, very small. So I used like straws and other little things to put it there. But at the end of the day, I just used a spoon. Now, I wanted to make sure that the chocolate gets everywhere, so I just shook the mold a bit to make sure that it gets everywhere, although you'll see when we are done that it didn't, unfortunately. Maybe it started setting before I did the shaking and it just didn't go everywhere. But anyway, after this I just put it into the fridge for about 30 minutes to an hour, I believe. And when I took it out, this was the result. Now, as I said, the chocolate didn't go that far into the mold and it didn't cover everything. So it does have these little holes here and there and it's not 100% in its shape. That's okay. At least it's much better than last time. Now, the thing is that this is actually full of chocolate. I mean, most of it is pretty much 100% chocolate. It's not hollow, which means that if I were to make the full figure, it would take a lot of chocolate and you wouldn't even be able to eat it that well. So that's why I put less in the hopes that it's gonna get on the edges when I shake it and it's gonna be hollow so that you can eat it as well. But that wasn't really the case. But I'm still happy of how it turned out. It's much better than last time and I did gain a lot more knowledge about chocolate after this. So if you want to see me do it again with maybe another figure that is a bit easier to make into a chocolate Yutus that has less detail and that we can actually make 100%, let me know in the comments. Also, as you can see, it does have a bit of residue, and that's probably because of the wax that was previously put into the mold. If you don't know, I did that last time with wax, and I guess this is the residue that you see on the chocolate right here, and I don't really want to eat that, at least not now. Maybe we are gonna do something crazy with it, so yeah. But this was pretty much it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think about my chocolate figure, and also tell me if I should make another one with a simpler figure that has less details. And also, if you are making anything Christmas related and also YouTube related, let me know or send me a picture on Instagram. I'll be very happy to see everything. Now, that's about it. Thanks very much for watching. See you next time.